verse 1 through 19. You may sit for the reading. Probably was going to read and preach at the same time. And it came to pass when David and his men were come to Ziklag on the third day that the Amalekites had invaded the south and Ziklag and smitten Ziklag and burned it with fire and had taken the women captives that were therein. They slew not any, either great or small, but carried them away and went on their way. So David and his men came to the city, and behold, it was burned with fire, and their wives and their sons and their daughters were taken captive. Put your hand and finger there. We're here in the text, we're seeing David, and at this time he was in a conflict with Saul. He was actually hiding from Saul, doing guerrilla style movement, attacks against the Philistines and the army. One, two. Huh? Okay, and so at this time, David, he was coming back from one battle, coming back to the city and where his family and his army was stationed at. And by the time he got back there, the enemy had came and destroyed the city and destroyed and took captive his family and the wives and daughters of his army, and that was in Ziklag. All right, so that's verse 3. Verse 4, it says, then David and the people that were with him lifted up their voices and wept until they had no more power to weep. Here it is, David, he is known to be a fighter. He is known to be a winner. He is known to be the one that slew the Goliath. He is known to be one that's just very name struck fear into the hearts of his enemies, the Philistines. And here he is, he comes back, a man of war, comes back to the city, and he is the victim of the very thing that he's the best at. All right? And so here it is, how is it that you actually lose at what you're the best at?
Right.
Verse 3, verse 4, verse 5 says, and David's two wives were taken captive, Ahinoam, the Jezreelites, and Abigail, the wife of Nabal, the Carmelite. Say, David was busy. Okay, you catch that later. All right, this is the short version, all right? Okay, and David was greatly distressed for the people spake of stoning him, because the soul of all the people that were grieved and every man for his sons and for his daughters. But David encouraged himself in the Lord, his God. So here it is, the setting is David, he comes back. He is now with his army. They come back to a destroyed city. Everybody's wives, daughters, families are taken captive. All the spoils that they've had are now taken captive and everything by their enemy. And now the people are turning against them. They're talking about stoning them because their leader took them into war, and now they come back, and while they're away, so everything was taken from them while they're away. What do you do when you actually lose at what you're the best at? What do you do? Well, the Bible then says David sat there and he was distressed. And he said, the first thing that he did, he encouraged himself in the Lord. Now, what does this actually mean? Encourage yourself in the Lord, your God. Well, you have to first understand that God has a plan.
Right.
God is in control. God knows all. And many times we don't understand it all and everything, but he knows it all. It's just distressing, though, when you find yourself you think you're walking in God's will, and you're moving and doing, what you thought you should do. You sacrifice, you practice, you put in the time, and the sacrifice of doing what it is. And then you find out, oh my gosh, that's not it. What do you do? Anybody can know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Of course, it's kind of an analogy here, too. our last, our Tuesday evening, where the choir went down to Oakland, and you know, God is, you know, if Jess is not known for anything, you know, for singing, amen. Yeah. You know, we did know we could sing. In fact, it was crazy. I mean, when we announced we were actually gonna go and be in the competition, people are already giving us the award. They're already giving us the title, best choir. Well, y'all gonna do this, y'all gonna do that. And I was like, nah, let's not go there yet. And everything, because they gotta compete, you gotta go to the thing and stuff. Got down there and everything, felt good about what we're doing, look good, all stuff. Got to the sound check. Let me tell y'all about the sound check. And right after the sound check, members from other choirs came up to us talking about that y'all got it, y'all win. The choirs that were participating in the thing, they came up to talking about, you know, y'all think y'all got it, like, y'all win. Y'all gonna take this. I'm like, don't tell it yet, don't say it yet, and everything. Then we got there. Then you saw what happened and everything. The Lord blessed us and all that. And next thing you know, we win. Mm-hmm. What do you do when you don't win at what you're the best at? Mm-hmm. When you put it all in line. Mm-hmm. Not like David, the Bible says David encouraged himself in the Lord. Many times, let's take it personally for you. Many times you've done all you could. You've stayed in the battle. You've tried to live right, do right. You tried to, you know, stay with the man. You know, stay with the woman. Do well in the marriage. Got the degree. Worked well at the job. The first one there at the job. Last one off. You know, I wouldn't say it wasn't perfect, but you did the best you could. Look at your name and say, you did the best you could. And bad things still happen to you. Yeah. Still got laid off. The marriage ended up still in divorce. Something just crazy worked out. And you're like, Lord, what happened? The city is destroyed. It seems like all my friends are kind of taken away. Things like that. What is going on? Now, I can't tell you that I don't feel like that distressed over this contest. That's just, you know, but it's the story, okay? So don't worry about me on that. I ain't trying to build the stress. But here the truth of the matter is that, you know, there are times in our life we feel like we've done all that we could do, and many times you did not receive what you should have received. Yes. David said, this is what David did. He encouraged himself in the Lord. And knowing that, he said, okay, Lord, this is the time where I'm gonna put my trust in you. I gotta trust your plan. I gotta trust your situation. You know what? Probably the biggest feeling that I had, I'm sitting there trying to smile on the stage in front of 20,000 people. There was two of them. Disappointment, and a shock, a constraint, and then a little embarrassment. I'm like embarrassed a little bit. I'm like, oh Lord, you didn't win. Like, what happened? I'm like, and after that, I just went blank. You know, I didn't know what was going on. I was just going through the movements. You're right, just mine. Everything, and then it's funny how you know, before the event, the concert, they treat you like stars and royalty and everything. They can't do enough for you. After the thing, they were like, "All right, God bless you, thank you, man." They pushed you out, and things like that. It's like, come on. We even had some wheelchairs in the behind and lady tea and things like that. They were trying to take the wheelchairs away. I said, they just start, you know, they didn't got healed or anything. They need a wheelchair. Can't keep up, wheelchair. That's what I said. And so, you know, I'm a little embarrassed there, you know. What am I going to say? Things like that, you know. That's how I got to trust God on this situation. I got to encourage myself in the plan, things like that. And so here is, and then the Lord looked at the scripture and did, and David asked the Lord, saying, what shall I do, Lord? Should I just stay here, or shall I pursue after this truth? Verse 8, he says, and David inquired the Lord, saying, shall I pursue after this truth? Shall I overtake them? And he answered them, pursue, for thou shalt surely overtake them, and without fail, recover all. Without fail, recover all. When hit a roadblock or an obstacle or seem like an obstacle, it's easy to go ahead and shut down, stop what you're doing, and then I'll always ask the question, well, am I in God's will? Am I in God's will in this situation? Did I do the right thing? Did I work, was I get credit? Was it my ego? Was my pride? Was it whatever it is, Was I really, then you'll have some folks that will tell you that you did the wrong thing. Uh-huh. They will criticize your opinion, criticize your stance, criticize, the whole situation, things like that. Why are you in a competition anyway? Y'all Genesis, why are you doing that? We got some of that little flack right there.
Make
you kind of wonder if he was right and stuff. So here it is. But David said, well, Lord, did I give you right? Shall I stay? Shall I just give up? And the Lord said, here's what you got to do. You have to pursue. Look at your name and say, pursue.
Pursue.
All right? And so he now was going to see a formula. Encourage, pursue. Encourage, then pursue. Encourage yourself to understand you have to trust the Lord. And then you have to keep it moving. Look at your next neighbor, keep it moving.
Keep it moving.
Keep it moving. Keep it moving. Keep moving. Pursue. Pursue. Even in, the best act of faith is being able to move while you're in fear.
Yes.
Your best act of faith and courage is to be able to move in your fear. In your fear. Pursue. Pursue. Go after what was lost. Oh Lord. Go after what was lost. And the promise is when you actually be encouraged, pursue, then guess what? You'll recover all. Look at your next neighbor. You're going to recover all. You're going to recover all. Encourage, pursue, and you shall recover all. So David decides to go ahead and do this. He says, well, I'm gonna get my army and we're gonna truck on out. Out of this army, 200 people said we're not going. Retire. All the people that start out with you are not gonna end up being with you. You can't be disappointed with that. Can't be disappointed. David said, okay, I'm gonna go anyway. I'm taking who I got and we're gonna pursue because this is what God said. This is what God said. Okay, so I might not have the title, but I still got the victory.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Watch out. I might not have the title, but I still got the victory. So after all that, then this video popped up with from Elijah, and I sent it over to our manager, James Evan of Oakland. He manages Evan Hawkins. He manages Lawrence Matthews. Some of the Bay Area gospel legends, like that gospel legends, and he manages us, or us, and Genesis. Well, we haven't given him a lot of work to do lately, but then this one has given him a lot of work, because now, he said, I was on the front row, and the place exploded. Now you have a buzz. 20,000 people were just going wild and crazy. Y'all took the arena. You may not got the prize, but you got the victory. So now there's a hope. There's 20,000 more people that know more about who Genesis Church is, Genesis Church Choir, things like that. Now that's something I can work with. Because now the exposure has gone up. And so send the piece. Who's not sending the video to everybody? I don't want to go saw it. It's just on who's on Facebook, who's on Twitter, things like that. Nobody can guys. Email. Email. Right, email. Okay, so we're gonna email you guys. Like that. Okay. And so here's the deal. So because it's such a great video, we start getting just great response from it from all over. In 2 days, we are now over 2,000 hits on that video.
Wow.
Yes, okay. Okay, so 225 for that. All right, so 22 50. Amen. That's on there. That's just 2 days. That's been popped up on there. That's the most we've ever had. All right, 2,300, all right. And so let me tell you, so even though we didn't place, we still got the victory.
Yeah.
Because now we've been able to impact not only those 20,000, but now it's going viral and it's really working and things like that all over the place. So somebody say pursue. And so we came up with a plan and said, well, this is what we're gonna do. I got a call from a friend of mine in Los Angeles that does video work and everything. He videotaped Norman Hutchins, gospel guy. Also, West Angeles does some work for them. He said, this would be a great time for a video, Pastor.
Yeah.
I said, really? I said, yeah, we talked earlier about that, about doing a video of the choir and things like that. So I said, I got no money. I didn't win nothing. He said, let's work things out. Let's come up with a plan to make it happen. And so right now we're planning to do a video shoot, mm-hmm. New Year's Eve.
Amen.
For the choir. All of us. The thing we have to do is we have to be encouraging of each other. You know, I was disappointed, not for myself, maybe for myself, but for our choir members. Put the time in, things like that. But then they start coming back to me and said, this is the best thing we've done. This is kind of great. This is cool. I've never done this before. And I was like, well, yeah, this is a kind of cool thing to do. And everything. And someone do it again.
Yeah.
Someone do it again.
Yeah.
And some people in South Carolina wants to do it again.
Yeah. Sure.
But y'all want us to do it again.
Yeah. Yeah.
So here's the thing. So you encourage yourself, you pursue, and then we cover all. Go to verse 17. David, he pursues the army. The story is he goes down to, while he's in pursuit, he finds one of the enemy's men and who was wounded and left for dead. He goes to him, he treats him kindly, and in exchange for his kindness, the man leads David to the secret hideout of the army, of the enemy, and stuff. So David goes down, takes him down there, and gets to verse 17, and said, David smote them from the twilight even unto the evening of the next day. So he just went in there, I can't say what I'm gonna say, went in there just really attacking, and he won. He, you know, you put it on the blank. Last part, take names, amen. And so after that, all day long, and there escaped not a man of them, save about 400 that ran away, which rolled on camels and fled. And verse 18, and David recovered all that the Amalekites had carried away, and David rescued his two wives. Verse 19, and there was nothing lacking to them, neither small nor great, neither sons nor daughter, neither spoil nor anything that had taken to them. David recovered all. I'm telling you right now, Genesis, what we feel was a loss really is a winner. It's a winner. It's we won that. We have the victory. And we're going to recover all. More people know about the church, know about the ministry, know about the choir, know about us, know about the work, things like that. And so here now we're going to recover it all. I expect in the next, before the year's out, we're going to see something magical happen in the atmosphere. And I want you to be encouraged. I want you to keep on pursuing. I want you to pray for October 11th when we meet with the bank that's coming in to talk about repurchasing this property.
Amen.
Amen. Somebody say, recover all. That's what we're about to do. We're about to recover it all. Recover it all. When you look at what we've been through, Genesis, we're already a miracle.
Yes.
You know, and what you've been through, individually, you're a miracle in everything. And the testimonies are in this place. It's huge. And the reason why you follow the formula, you encouraged yourself in the Lord. And then after that, you pursued, you kept on moving, kept on going, kept on pushing. And then after that, because of that, you are going to recover it all. Eyes have not seen, ears have not heard. What the Lord has in store for us is beyond comprehension. We have to trust God in this situation. We have to trust God like we've done in all the other situations. We have to trust Him. Trust, look at somebody and say, trust God. Be encouraged. Be encouraged. Be encouraged. Church, be encouraged. We can hang our heads low. We have to hang up high. Amen. And walk in faith. Walk knowing that God has it all in control. Amen. Look at somebody and say, encourage.
Encourage.
Pursue.
Pursue.
Recover all.
Recover all.
Encourage.
Encourage.
Pursue.
Pursue.
Recover all.
Recover.
Encourage.
Encourage.
Pursue.
Pursue.
Recover all.
Recover all.
Come on, get God's plan covered.